Thank you. We're reading Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 2, Chapter 10, text number 17. Pranena Kshipata.
Pranena
Kshipata.
Pranena Kshipata.
Chat,
chat,
antara,
antara,
jayate,
jayate,
vibho,
vibho,
pipasato,
pipasato,
jatsata,
jatsata,
cha,
cha,
pran,
pran,
mukham,
mukham,
nirabhidyate,
nirabhidyate,
nirabhidyata, Pranenakshipita sutrit.
Pranenakshipita sutrit.
Pranenakshipita sutrit.
Pranenakshipita sutrit.
Antara jayate vibho.
Antara jayate vibho.
Antara jayate vibho.
Antara jayate vibho.
Vipassato jatsa tatascha.
Vipassato jatsa tatascha.
Vipassato jatsa tatascha.
Vipassato jatsa tatascha.
Brahmukam niravidyata.
Brahmukam niravidyata.
Brahmukam niravidyata.
Brahmukam niravidyata.
Pranenakshipata sutrit.
Pranenakshipata sutrit.
Antara jayate vibho.
Antara jayate vibho.
Vipassato jatsa tascha.
Vipassato jatsa tascha.
Pranmukham niravidyata.
Pranmukham niravidyata.
Pranenakshipata sutrit.
Pranenakshipata sutrit.
Antara jayate vibho.
Antara jayate vibho.
Vipassato jatsa tascha.
Vipassato jatsa tascha.
Pranmukham niravidyata.
Pranmukham niravidyata. Pranenakshipata sutrit.
Pranenakshipata sutrit.
Antara jayate vibho.
Antara jayate vibho.
Vipassato jatsatascha.
Vipassato jatsatascha.
Pranmukham niravidyata.
Pranmukham niravidyata. Pranenakshipata sutrit.
Pranenakshipata sutrit.
Antara jayate vibho.
Antara jayate vibho.
Vipassato jatsatascha.
Vipassato jatsatascha.
Pranmukham niravidyata.
Pranmukham niravidyata.
Thank you.
Shri Guru Vaishnavamsa,
sarvajatam sahagana bhagnatam vidham tam sajivam sarvaitam sarvadutam bhagana sahitam krishna chaitanya devam shri radha krishna padam sahagana lalita shri vishakha vidham sarvam hey krishna karuna sindhu by the Virata Purush generated hunger and thirst, and when he desired to drink and eat, the mouth opened. So the living force, meaning the spirit soul within the heart of all living entities, was agitated by the Virata Purush. And the Virata Purush is described by Srila Prabhupada as being the sum total of all living entities. And so the Virata Purush desired hunger, he felt hunger and thirst. So hunger and thirst came from the Virata Purush, and in this way it manifested in the hearts of all living entities. So because the desire for hunger, the desire to eat and to drink was there in the Virata Purush, so this desire came to all the living entities. And desiring to eat and to drink, we have to have a mouth. And Prabhupada describes here, the mouth is the symbolic representation of all sense organs. We need the mouth to eat and to drink. Of course, the mouth is also important because from the mouth it generates sound. We use the tongue. Of course, the tongue is there within the mouth. So all of the different senses are activated under the inspiration from the Virata Purush.
所有的感官的做功能呢，都是在维拉达的树，维拉达的树的刺激下产生的。
So the initial desire comes from the Virata Purush. captured all the street dogs.
他们生命都受到威胁，也许呢，政府呢就会派人来捕捉这些野狗。
So all different living entities are suffering and enjoying according to their past activities.
所有的生物体在享受或受苦，这都是由于他们过往的业力导致的。
Some living entities are put into the body of dogs and they live very comfortably, and other dogs live very uncomfortably.
有些灵魂被置于这个宠物狗的身体里，所以它们生活很舒适，而另外一些呢，它们在野狗的身体里就很不舒服。
So this is their karma. They're suffering their karma. They have the karma to put them into the body of a dog.
这就是他们过往的业力导致他们投生在狗的躯体里。
Some dogs are fortunate and other dogs are not.
而有些狗狗呢，它们是幸运的，还有另外一些狗它们不幸。
Prabhupada said, dog is the most condemned creature.
帕帕德说，狗是最受到谴责的生物。
Useless animal.
它们没有用途。
We don't give importance to dogs, but at the same time, if the dog has an interest in Krishna consciousness, if he has an attachment to devotees, then we can give mercy to the dogs.
我们不重视狗。但是倘若这个狗也依附奉献者，我们也会给它以仁慈。
Just like it's described in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, how Shivananda Sen was going to Jagannath Puri with a group of devotees, and a dog began to follow them.
在 Chaitanya Charitamrita 当中 ，Shivananda Sen 呢，他带领奉献者去将那库尔朝圣，有一条狗就尾随着奉献者。
And so because the dog was following, Shivananda Sen arranged to get the dog if he should get Krishna. Because this dog was following the
group, so Shivananda Sen arranged
to get. And even when they had to go on the boat, Shivananda Sen paid money to the boatman to allow the dog on the boat.
甚至当奉献者乘船渡河的时候 ，Shivananda Sen 也付钱让这条狗也乘船。
And one day, the devotees somehow forgot to give the dog prasadam, and the dog disappeared.
有一天，奉献者忘记了给这一条狗 prasadam 吃，结果这条狗消失了。
And when the dog disappeared, Shivananda Sen felt very guilty, and he observed fasting. He wouldn't take prasadam.
那当狗消失了之后，希曼达拉现在感到很内疚，他就一天都戒食不吃。
So this was the mercy of a devotee on even the dog.
这就是奉献者给狗的仁慈。
There was a great devotee, his name was Rasikananda. He was a disciple of Shyamananda Pandit.
有位伟大的奉献者 Rasikananda, 他是 Shyamananda Pandit 的门徒。
Shyamananda Pandit had studied at the Gurukula of Jiva Goswami along with Narottama Das and Srinivasacharya.
Shyamananda Pandit 和 Srinivas以及拿尔坦达斯塔库尔一起在吉瓦郭斯瓦米的学校里学习。
And so, Rasikananda was the first disciple of Shyamananda.
Rasikananda 是 Shyamananda 的首位门徒。
And he was a very great devotee. And he had disciples. He had some mad elephant became his disciple.
他是特别伟大的奉献者。他收的门徒当中有一个门徒是一条野老虎，大象。
大象。Rasikananda had gone to this village where the head of the village was known to be a very big thief, a dacoit. He was not a good man. But Rasikananda had gone there and he was preaching to the man.Telling the man that he should become a devotee.
Rasikananda 去一个村庄，这个村子的村长，他是一个是一个强盗，是一个是一个无赖，然后他特别糟糕。结果 Rasikananda 就劝说他成为奉献者。
So the chief of the village said to Rasikananda, he said, "Just now there's a mad elephant destroying my village."He said, "I want you to go there." He said, "Your holy name is the holy name is so powerful. You go to that elephant and tame him."
这个强盗猴子就跟西格曼达说，刚刚呢有头野象会践踏了我们的村庄，我希望你去那里把它驯服。
If you can bring this animal under your control, then I will accept you as a being a great guru.
如果你能把这头野兽驯服，我就接受你是一位伟大的奉献者。
So Rasikananda immediately got up and he went to the place where the elephant was destroying the village.
Rasikananda 立刻就站起身，就来到这个风，野象的地方。
And Rasikananda immediately went and stood in front of the elephant and told the elephant, "You chant the holy name and surrender to Krishna."
Rasikananda 就勇敢地走到这头野象面前，就告诉他。
And the elephant looked at Rasikananda, and then tears came in his eyes, and he fell at the feet of Rasikananda. So Rasikananda accepted the elephant as his disciple, and gave him the name Gopal.And this elephant would regularly come to see Rasikananda and to offer obeisances to him. On another occasion, when the head of the village saw all this, then he also surrendered and took initiation from Rasikananda.
当这个强盗看到这一幕情景的时候，他也臣服了Rasikananda。
And then another time, Rasikananda was in the forest, there were tigers, and these tigers also became devotees. Rasikananda would arrange it, and he would put rice out for the prasad for the tigers. So he was a really powerful spiritual teacher.That even the animals could become his disciple. Of course, Lord Chaitanya was also a very great spiritual teacher, and he and the wild animals in Jarakanda, they all became gentle by his association. All the ferocious animals became gentle, and they embraced the gentle animals like the deer.
那些猛兽，它们变得温和了，开始拥抱那些像鹿这样温和的动物。
So Lord Chaitanya was so powerful, he could convert even the animals.
柴丹亚是这么强大有力。
So in the modern age, we see also how great devotees like Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada could go into the heart of New York, where the people were the most fallen and the most degraded, and he could make them into devotees. So Srila Prabhupada describes how the Mayavani sannyasis, they were so sinful, they could not chant the holy name of Krishna. Although they were renounced people, they had renounced the material world, they did not have any piety to chant the holy name of the Lord.But when Lord Chaitanya went to the animals, he could get the wild animals to chant. And Srila Prabhupada, when he went to New York, although the people there were all sinful,They had no piety, but they could also chant Hare Krishna. But the Mayavadis, they cannot chant Hare Krishna.
而
They cannot utter the holy name of the Lord. They could say Chaitanya, but they could not say the holy name of Lord Sri Krishna. So this proves that the holy name can only manifest on people who are not offenders to the Lord. Because the Mayavadis are offenders to the Lord, so the holy name will not appear on their tongue. But the young people, the Western people, the acid heads, Allen Ginsberg describes the meth monsters, the acid heads, all these kind of crazy people in the material world. Although they were all crazy for sense gratification, they were not offenders to the holy name, and therefore when Prabhupada chanted, they could also chant.
但是像西方那些乐队，他们虽然他们生活很狂野，但因为他们不是冒犯者，所以他们能够唱圣。So
the holy name manifests. People may be sinful, they may be totally absorbed in sense gratification, but so long as they have not offended the holy name of the Lord, because they're not offensive to the Lord, they can chant, they can be delivered.
所以那些有的人，他们可能是很罪恶的，而且是感恩享乐者，但是因为他们不是冒犯者，他们可以称颂圣名。
So how to deliver the Mayavadis, how to deliver these people impersonalists who are offenders to the holy name?
如何拯救这些Mayavadi，他们是圣名的冒犯者，让他们也称颂圣名呢？
We have to create some piety in them.
必须在他们身上创造出虔诚活动。
Just like Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to meet the Mayavadi sannyasis when he was in Benares.
就像说，Chaitanya Mahaprabhu在贝纳勒斯去见那些假象龙人时。
The Mayavadi sannyasis had all gathered there in the home of one Brahmana, and that Brahmana man had also invited Lord Chaitanya.
这些假象僧人是齐聚在一位婆罗门家中，而主陈太太也应邀来了。And
the Mayavadi sannyasis, when they saw Lord Chaitanya come there, they were impressed by his effulgence, because he exhibited the effulgence of the Supreme Lord Narayan.
当这些假象僧人是看到主陈太太身上 放出放着出，哪吒呢？身上放出像哪吒放着出的这个浓浓的光灿的时候，他们被吸引的。So
for the Mayavadi sannyasis, their goal is to become one with Narayan.
这些 Mayavadi sannyasi 目标是想要和哪吒呢合二为一。
When you meet a Mayavadi sannyasi, you should offer respect to them by saying Namo Narayan.
见到一位 Mayavadi sannyasi 的时候，应该向他。
In other words, we will say, I offer my obeisances to you who is one with Lord Narayan. So for the Mayavadis, the goal is that oneness, to get to Yuja Mukti, to become one with Lord Narayan.
这些马拉的三家是目标是有三有主目的和主和拿拉的合一。So
when Lord Chaitanya came there, they saw his effulgence, and they thought, oh, he has already become Narayan.
所以当这些马拉的三家是看到主陈家的光灿的时候，就想啊，他已经和拿拉合一了。He's
already liberated.
他已经解脱了。And
so they became very respectful to him.
他们就对他毕恭毕敬。
And Prakashananda Saraswati, who was the head of the Mayavadi sannyasis, he personally came and brought Lord Chaitanya in to the room.
他和神安的沙斯巴提，也就是他们的首领，亲自拉着主差的那手，带到会众当中。
And he was very nice towards Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
他对主差的拉巴布非常友善。
And because he behaved in that manner, he got the benefit of Agyata Sukriti, performing pious activities unknowingly.
因为他的这般举止呢，他就获得了 Agyata Sukriti， 也就是不知不觉的潜能活动。
And the result of that Agyata Sukriti was he got association with Lord Chaitanya, and Lord Chaitanya explained Vedanta Sutra to him.
由于这种 Agyata Sukriti， 他和神安那萨萨提就和主差他俩联谊，向他聆听了 Vedanta Sutra。
And then Lord Chaitanya got all the Mayavadi sannyasis to chant Hare Krishna.
而主差的俩让所有这些妈妈的小孩子唱诵 Hare Krishna。
They all chanted the holy name of the Lord。
他们全都开始唱诵主的圣名了。
And then Lord Chaitanya took prasadam with all the Mayavadi sannyasis。
之后主差的俩和所有妈妈的sannyasis一起荣耀不杀的。
Because they all chanted Hare Krishna, so they become devotees。Usually Lord Chaitanya would never take prasada with the Mayavadi sannyasis. But after they chanted Hare Krishna, he accepted, now they have become Vaishnavas. And they all took prasada together. So in this way, Lord Chaitanya brought the Mayavadi sannyasis to Krishna consciousness. Well, Krishna consciousness is in every living entity. It has to be awakened. Just like here in this verse, it says, the desire to drink and eat was created.And with that desire to eat and drink, the mouth was opened. It's not enough just to have a mouth, you have to open the mouth to eat and drink. And then all the senses function around the mouth.Okay, any questions?
有没有问题？
Yes?
Maharaj, I want to ask a question about Gaura Kishori Babaji. I was reading like he was doing his bhajana, he didn't see anybody, he didn't want anybody to approach him. So I just wonder how should we understand his behavior? Was he very elevated? He didn't need any sadhusanga?And he didn't let people approach him. Is he not very merciful of, you know, sharing the knowledge? But just want to see it from the proper perspective. 我想问一个关于高尔基沙瑞巴这个问题，然后为什么他就是他是拒绝所有人来见他，他不想别人靠近他，是因为他不想把这个不善趣传递给其他人，没有这种仁慈吗？还有一个问题是因为他自己，是因为他自己本身很高级，所以他不需要三六三娘。
Gaurakishore Das Babaji is a Babaji. He's not a Vaishnava. He's not a. He's engaged in bhajan. He's not engaged in preaching.
Gaurakishore Das Babaji, 因为他是 Babaji 的身份，所以 Babaji 呢，他们一般不传教。
These people who have taken the Babaji vow, they have completely detached themselves from the material world. And they just do bhajan, they just do their own spiritual practice. They don't worry about other people. So they have that.Mood that everybody else is already engaged in their own different spiritual activities. They're all doing their own thing. Some people, they're all doing their service to Krishna in different ways. So Gaurakishodas Babaji was that kind of person. He didn't need to associate, didn't like to associate with other people.
Gaurakishodas Babaji 就是有这种这样的人，他就不跟别的人联系。
It says one point he went to live in the public toilet, a very dilapidated, dirty, smelly public toilet, and he went and sat there to chant the Hare Krishna mantra.
曾经有一次呢，Gaurakishodas Babaji，他就来到一个公共厕所，这厕所呢都已经破败不堪，发出了恶臭，没有人去打，但他就坐来唱着玛尔贝。And
when people would come and disturb him, he would tell them, "You come and sit here with me, and we will chant Hare Krishna together."
当有人来打扰他的时候，他就邀请他们，跟我一起来厕所里唱Hare Krishna。And
they would run away. They didn't want to.
而这些人都被吓跑了。So
he was that kind of person. It's generally Babaji's, they don't preach, they just do their bhajan.
所以Babaji呢，通常就是不传教，他们只是做自己的巴萨里修行的人。
Even it said the Goswamis of Vrindavan, they were not so much active preaching, they were doing more their own bhajan. They would do chanting, they would go to the holy places. They wrote some books. But mainly their business was chanting the holy name and reading the scriptures.
他们主要的活动是唱诵圣名，还有写经典。
And worshipping the deity.
他们也崇拜神像。They
do these things.
他们从事这些活动。
They didn't worry so much about preaching.
他们对于传播活动呢，并不是十分的焦虑。
So there's Bhajan Anandi and Ghost of Anandi. There are two kinds of devotees. Bhajan Anandi, he simply does his own sadhana, his own bhajan. He doesn't preach. But the Ghost of Anandi, he will try to give Krishna consciousness to others.
Thank you for the lecture. Gurudev, my question is about the previous lecture. To what extent does God create causes and effects? And to what extent do we? So, what is we is of creation?
I can't understand what you're saying. Can you speak clear?
Sorry. To what extent does God create causes and effects? And to what effects do we? In what degree does God create causes and effects? This is about human scriptures.
To what extent?
God creates cause and effects.
God creates cause and effect.
Yes, and to what extent do we?
To what extent do we create?
We create, yes.
第三部分就在哪种程度上神创造了原因和结果，而在哪种程度上我们创造了原因和结果。Well, we learn from Lord Rama's prayers that Lord Krishna is Sarva Karana Karana, is the cause of all causes。我们从Rama Samhita呢得知，主是Sarva Karana Karana，他是万源之源。
所以最原初的原因呢，是来自主 Krishna。
All causes, everything comes about by the will of Lord Krishna.
所以一切呢，都是依照主 Krishna 的意志而发生的。
the effect is the result of that desire of Lord Krishna.
这个结果就体现在这个主 Krishna 意志它发生的那个结果。
So we may have desires, but our desires cannot be independent of the desire of Lord Krishna.
我们也可能有自己的心愿，但是我们的心愿无法独立于主 Krishna 的意志。
We're not independent. We're controlled.
我们是被控制者，我们不是独立的。
Either we're under the material energy, or we're under the spiritual energy.
我们或是处在物质能量的控制之下，或者在灵性能量控制之下。
If we're under the material energy, then we're controlled by the material nature.
如果我们在物质能量控制之下，就在被物质能量控制，就在物质属性之下。
And if we have surrendered to Lord Krishna, then we're under the spiritual energy.
如果我们臣服归顺呢，我们就在灵性能量控制下。
And the spiritual energy is under the control of the directly by the Supreme Lord.
而灵性能量是直接由至尊主控制。
So the cause of everything is arranged by Krishna.
所以万事万物的根源也是由归顺安排的。
And the effects will be depending on our own qualification.
而这个结果取决于我们自己的资格。
How we use everything in the service of Lord Krishna.
我们是如何去运用万事万物，我们所拥有的来服务 Krishna.
If Lord Krishna wants, then the devotee can produce wonderful effects.
如果 Krishna 希望的话，奉献者可以创造出美妙的结果。
And if we're rebellious and we're against the will of Krishna, then we create havoc, we create disaster and confusion.
如果我们具有反叛心态，违背父亲的意志，就会创造灾难和后果。
So, we're like that. We're under the direction of the energy of the Lord.
所以无论怎样，我们都是在主的能量的运作指挥之下。
But we have independence. Independence is to choose. Either we'll surrender to Krishna or we'll surrender to Maya.
我们的独立性是我们有选择权，我们是臣服玛雅还是臣服
Krishna. It's up to us which way we want to go.
取决于我们想要走哪方向。
You surrender to Maya, you come immediately under the material energy.
如果选择了玛雅，就立刻在物质能量控制下。
And we surrender to Krishna, we're under Krishna's control.
如果我们选择 Krishna 就在 Krishna 的控制之下
Under the direction of Krishna's divine energy
是在 Krishna 神圣的能量之下
So that is our independence
这就是我们的独立性
We have that opportunity at every moment
我们时时刻刻都有这种选择的机会
Want to surrender to Krishna Krishna will already facilitate
如果我们想要臣服 Krishna Krishna 也会协助我们帮助我们
ButWe want to go against Krishna, we want to take shelter of Maya, Krishna facilitates.
但是如果我们反对 Krishna, 在想要去 Maya 的控制下，那 Krishna 也帮助我们。
We get the results.
那我们就要咎由自取了。
It's not karma.
所以这跟业力有没有关系？
Once you surrender to material energy, then it's karma.
如果选择臣服物质能量的话，就会制造自己的业力。
But we don't have to. We don't have to be under the control.
但是我们没有必要，就一定要处在业力的控制下。
Devotional service is not karma.
因为奉献服务它跟业力没有关系。
So, Maharaj, if a person sometimes he performs devotional service, sometimes he does.Material activities, does it really depend on his attitude, his surrender, whether he's under the control of Krishna or sometimes under the control of Krishna, sometimes under the control of the Lord?
Well, it's not karma. At every moment you have that free will, you have that independence to choose. Of course, some you may figure out from the past life, somebody's born in a very good family, they put into the family of devotees, and they from the beginning of their life they have the opportunity to be with devotees and to chant the holy name and to eat vegetarian, eat prasadam. So you could think that, well, that was your karma. But still, everyone has free will, you have independence.
您您说，有的人从一出生到他，他们在封建的家庭，他就有机会来就从事一些风外活动，并且从事素食，这也是他们自己的业力。但是在另外一方面，每个人他还是有自己的选择权，独立性。There
are people, Naradamas, Naradamas, they've got the opportunity for devotional service, but they don't take it. They may be born in a very nice family, a good opportunity for devotion, but they don't take it. They don't have to, they don't feel any attraction, any significance to it. And they just want to be materialistic, sense enjoyers.
但是他们却选择物质主义的生活，选择了赶快享乐的生活。Everyone has to choose what they make their own destiny, how you make use of the human life.
And other people, they just waste the opportunity.
如果利用这个机会，有的人好好的利用了机会，有的人却浪费了这个良机。
They may be in the mode of goodness, but they have no interest in transcendence. So now, back to Rajendra.